Welcome to Ask the Allergist. Today we are joined by Dr. Michael Blase, Clinical Professor of Pediatrics at the Medical College of Georgia at Augusta University and Executive Medical Director of the American College of Allergy, Asthma, and Immunology. Dr. Blase, mold growth is a serious problem when homes are flooded after major storms such as hurricanes. What should people with mold allergy do, and is there a treatment that can help control symptoms?
Well, mold can be a major problem, especially last year with the flooding that occurred in Texas and Florida and Puerto Rico. Homes can develop mold very rapidly. In fact, the EPA says within 48 hours, there can be significant mold growth after water, in fact, is flooded into a home. So it's very important for as rapidly as possible to clean the mold from the home so that problems, in fact, ideally don't develop. So if there are articles that, in fact, got flooded, they should either be dried or, say, something like a couch, which really can't be cleaned. It should be, in fact, thrown out. All the carpet, drapery, any place where water collects there needs to be cleaned or thrown out. And a real problem can be sheetrock. So all that sheetrock would need to be removed and all the insulation behind that. And sometimes you need to bring in a professional using a bleach solution to really help as far as clearing out the studs. Now, mold is irritating to everybody. It can irritate the eyes and irritate the nose, cause respiratory problems and severe coughing. But it can be really a severe problem for patients with mold allergy. So again, they can develop severe eye problems and nasal problems, and it can trigger severe life-threatening asthma. So obviously, the first thing is to try to clean up and avoid the mold as quickly as possible. Get on proper medications. If it's related to nasal allergy problems, the antihistamines, intranasal corticosteroids. If asthma, to get on proper medication, the different inhaled corticosteroids, short-acting beta agonists, and it may even take some of the more stronger medications that we factor and use in severe asthma. And for some patients, there may be the role of allergen immunotherapy to desensitize them to the mold that they're allergic to.
The mission of Allergy and Asthma Network is to end needless death and suffering due to asthma, allergies, and related conditions. We aim to do this through outreach, education, advocacy, and research. Visit us online at allergyasthmanetwork.org for reliable resources, and share this video with your family, friends, and colleagues. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time on Ask the Allergist.